Justin Limble and Brandon Kinzer in row one. Justin Ratliff, Johnny Wheeler, row two. Jason Barrett, Timmy Taylor, row three. J.L. Musin, row number four. At the cone, eyes on him, green's out, here we go. Kinzer will bring him through, lead the opening lap. Limble will be second, Ratliff third, Wheeler fourth, Barrett fifth, Taylor sixth, Muse seventh. Super late model heat two, you need to be in staging. Modified heat one to staging, please. Brandon Kinzer out of Allen, Kentucky, and one of the Jimmy Mars built MB custom chassis with a Gurdy race engine making a horsepower, showing the way over the Swartz chassis to Bullock powered machine. Dustin Linville here in the early going of Good Neighbor Pharmacy Super Late Model qualifying heat number one. And Kinzer and Limble working the high side through three and four, and also working through the middle and top shelf of turn one and two there. Ratliff rides in third, Wheeler is fourth, Barrett fifth, and it's Taylor and Muse. Six laps official, the work field working lap number seven as we speak. There'll be seven down right there, three to go. And race leader Brandon Kinzer going to have to work past the slower car of J.L. Muse as they work off turn two. Down the back straightaway, he'll put Muse a lap down into turn number three. As the two lap to go signal has been given, two laps remaining here in tonight's Good Neighbor Pharmacy Super Late Model first qualifying heat race of the night. Brandon Kinzer working off turn number four, one lap to go. And down the back straightaway for the final time off of turn number four. Allen, Kentucky's Brandon Kinzer will be your winner. Dustin Limble will go second. Justin Ratliff will finish third. Johnny Wheeler comes home in fourth. Jason Barrett completes the top five. Third to 16 of Justin Ratliff. Second to D8 of Dustin Linville. And grabbing the win in heat race number one. In the Kinzer Motorsports owned MB Custom Chassis with a Gurdy Race Engine sponsored by Kinzer Drilling, Quality Oil and Gas, the Will Kinzer Foundation for Autism Research, and Arch Radiator Service. Out of Allen, Kentucky, big round of applause for Brandon Kinzer. Modified heat one. Modified heats one and two. Modified heats one and two to staging, please. Skylar Marler in the 11. Michael Chilton in the 97 will bring him to green. Eyes on him. Green's out. Here we go. Brandon Kinzer's earned the pole for the Junebug. Who's going to earn the outside pole? They are almost three wide for second. They're off turn number two. The brothers Marler, Skylar to the outside of the 11. Mike to the inside of the 157. They race for second and third. Tommy Bailey sets in a fourth. Donnie Sullivan fifth. Robert Luttrell Jr. sixth. All this going on behind race leader Michael Chilton in the number 97. Chilton showing the way here in the early going of this one. Skylar Marler second, Mike Marler third, Tommy Bailey fourth, Donnie Sullivan fifth, Robert Luttrell Jr. is sixth. Modified heats one and two, we need you in staging, please. Modified heats one and two, we need you in staging, thank you. The 75 of Luttrell, he rolls his machine into the infield. His heat race done. Thank you. Halfway signal down on this one. We got five scored, five remain. Chilton showing the way as the Marler brothers getting dicey for the runner-up spot. Skyler has it, and older brother Mike wants it. As they work off four coming at you down Main Street right here with six laps now in the books. Michael Chilton puts another lap in the books at seven complete. He shows the way. Skyler Marler is second. Mike Marler third. Tommy Bailey fourth. Donnie Sullivan fifth. As the two lap to go signal goes down on this one, two laps to go. Chilton continuing to lead the way in the number 97 Rocket chassis. He'll work off turn number four. He's going to see the white flag. One lap to settle the issue here in Good Neighbor Pharmacy Super Late Model qualifying heat number two. And off of turn number four, South Isaac, Kentucky's Michael Chilton, the winner of Good Neighbor Pharmacy Super Late Model Heat 2. Skyler Marler will be second. Mike Marler will be third. Tommy Bailey will finish in fourth in the 11 with the one of Donnie Sullivan coming home fifth. Your top three finishers, third to 157 of Mike Marler, second to 11 of Skyler Marler. And picking up the win in Good Neighbor Pharmacy Super Late Model Heat 2 in his own Rocket chassis with a Mike Bullock race engine, sponsored by Caton Industrial Painting, Chilton Lawn Maintenance, Genesis Shocks.
wide.
Row number one, WD-40, got to be Wyatt Cummins in row number two. No, well, okay, we'll do that. Wyatt in row one. Row number two is number 11, Shane Workman, and Chad Reynolds in number 98. That's row inside row. 1, 2, and 3. Outside row, 1, 2, and 3. Going to be Michael Kennedy in 77. Alex McWilliams driving number 1. And Cheryl Schrader in number 70. That's your outside line. This is your street stock division. As they come to the line. Oh, yeah, looking good. Here we go. I don't know, but somebody didn't feed the squirrels under the hood. Something's not right. Yellow flag gonna fly as I think we got debris. Let's see what we got this time around. As we bring it off out of the corner of turn number 3 and 4. Looking good. Yep. Here we go. Back to the line. Alex McWilliams with lap number 1. Followed up by Cheryl Schrader. Wyatt Cummins going to round out this field here in the WD-40. Michael Kennedy. Looks like we lost Michael Kennedy on that pass by the flag stand. We're down to 3 cars. Alex McWilliams, he is half track, 2nd place. Man, this guy is rocking. White flag gonna fly. Cheryl battling it out with Wyatt as they come to the line. And the checkers are flying. And Wyatt Cummins is singing the Loose Wheel song as it goes bouncing around turn 4. It's coming back, Wyatt. Just sit tight. Oh, it's excellent, everything. He's like, wow, I'll never find that wheel. And then all of a sudden, there it is. Old car, Cheryl Schrader's old car, number 70. Then you got Oakley Gillespie in number 94. You got the 85 of Scott Blackwell. 87, I'm sorry, 87. Scott Blackwell. And then Justin Hill is going to be driving the number 37 to the inside row, number 3. I need you staging. Open wheel division. You will be coming up next. Open wheelers, I need you staging. Open wheel division. Alright, I was going to say, David, get up there with the rest of them. There you go. All right, they're kind of staggered. David needs to come up just a little bit more, but I guess it's okay. Here we go. Looks like Albert's going to go high and wide off of the corner of number one and two and down the back straightaway. Here comes this. Where did this other car come from? Scott Blackwell, he says, here I am, guys. Albert Ritt's going to try to hold him off, but the way he come out of that corner, I don't know. Looks like it's going to be a race off into turn number three and four. Scott Blackwell and Albert Ritt, and it's going to be at the line. Scott with a half a car length. David McGill high and wide battling it out with Oakley as they go around turn one and two. Now it looks like Scott's going to hold his own here in the back straightaway as he takes the lead full throttle at the line. Coming on lap number four, ladies and gentlemen, lap number four at the checkered flag stand is going to be Scott Blackwell and the Albert Ritt in the number 70 car. Lap four, David McGill and me too. And battling it out back here in the back, Justin Hill and Oakley Gillespie. Lap five at the line. Watch it. Scott Blackwell got a really decent lead going on here. The white flag displayed, and one more lap around Thunder Hill. Going to do it for Scott Blackwell. Scott Blackwell followed up by Albert Ritt. As the checkers are in hand, third place, I don't know. It's looking like David McGill as they come back to the line. Yep, David's got it along with fourth position belonging to Oakley Gillespie. And Justin Hill going to round out the field. Williams in the number 14. Brian Mars will be driving the M33 to the outside. And put your hands together for 87, Mr. Blackwell.
His wife, Sandra Stout, and Gus Chilton, we're honoring them. Race fans, put your hands together for the drivers of the Pony Division. Out of turn number four, flagman Ricky Lau, green flag in hand, 15 laps in the Pony Division. Sportsman cars, need you in staging. Sportsman cars, need you in staging.
Sportsman needs you in staging. Sportsman needs you in staging. Caution on the speedway. River car turn around in the infield. Turn around in turn four. Tony Turpin leads the field. Derek Dugan in second place. Max Stout in third. Ryan Wade in fourth. And the 146 of James Sharp in fifth as they round turn three and four. Green flag racing, fans. Ladies and gentlemen, as Max Stout leads the way, Derek Dugan in second. And here comes the checker. It's going to be Donnie Turpin with the win. Derek Dugan in second. Max Stout in third. That is your unofficial top three for tonight's race. As Donnie Turpin takes the checkered flag, flagman Ricky Lyle will step down from the flag stand to give him his checkered flag so that he can make a big round of applause and make some noise.
One more time, let him hear you. The winner of the $300 15 mile feature. He had them all. Got on the five machine, Donnie Turpin. All right, race fans, he's making his way over to the microphone. Donnie Turpin, he led all 15 of them tonight.
Hey, Donnie, come here real quick. Before you do that, let's get this out.
Donnie's making his way over here. Gus Chilton's daughter, Peggy, Jay Duncan Ford's, Keith Adcock is here. Donnie, you led all 15 of them tonight. I know you got some folks you want to thank.
I blowed up last night at Sweetwater, and they worked all night to get me going for tonight. And I want to thank every one of them for helping me last night.
All right, race fans, they put the race car together today to get him going. Put your hands together one more time for Donnie Turpin. I'm going to turn it back over now to Ann Harvey. He's going to give you the starting honors for tonight's Sportsman Race.
Thank you very much, Dustin.
The number one, and man, was he screaming earlier during the heat race. Number 87, Scott Blackwell. Here we go! Oh, David McGill in the Me Too car. He's trying to go right down the middle there and he got shut down.
On a Friday afternoon. Oh, we got tag. Middle to middle momentum as the checker flies. Second place belonging to Albert Ricks as they come to the line. Oh, I don't know on third and second. Or third and fourth, rather. We'll find out and I'll let you know.
And the field rolls away. Two by two double file, just like Noah took the animals on the ark. All right, race fans, Ponderosa Speedway, the 15th annual Hugh Junebug Rolling Memorial. We want you on your feet. Wave your hands and caps in the air to your favorite driver. Wish them Godspeed for the next 35 laps here at Ponderosa Speedway this evening, the 15th annual Hugh Junebug Rolling. Here they are. Brandon Kinzer in the 18, Michael Chilton in the 97 at the white line and cone here off turn four. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime. Kinzer and Chilton side by side just like they started, and Chilton will lead them off turn number four to lead lap number one. Three wide for second off of turn two. Kinzer, Skyler Marler, and Dustin Linville. Linville in the basement, Marler in the middle, Kinzer up top. Kinzer will come out of there with the second spot. Chilton showing the lead. Brandon Kinzer second, Skyler Marler third, as Mike Marler and Dustin Lynn will duke it out side by side for the fourth spot. Off of turn number four, put Mike Marler into position number four. Five laps in the books this time by Michael Chilton, continuing to lead the way. Brandon Kinzer second, Skyler Marler third, Mike Marler fourth, Dustin Linville fifth as the field goes around the slower car of Robert Luttrell Jr. Justin Ratliff is sixth, Tommy Bailey seventh, Johnny Wheeler eighth, Donnie Sullivan ninth, Jason Barrett tenth. Chilton looking good in the early going here of this one. He'll have the slower cars, the duo of J.L. Muse in the 375 and the 5 of Timmy Taylor. The next cars, he's going to have to work in traffic here as he exits off turn number four. Chilton going to try to work to the outside of Muse down into turn number three. That let Brandon Kinzer close up on him a bit, and he'll work around the outside of Timmy Taylor right there. Nine in the books, the field working lap number 10 right here as Chilton setting a toward pace out in front. We've got 10 scored right there, this time by 10 down, 25 to go. Chilton showing away, Kinzer second, Skyler Marler third, Mike Marler fourth, Dustin Limbo continues to hold down the final spot in the top five as Chilton will have to work the cars of Donnie Sullivan and Jason Barrett now down into turn number one. He'll put the one of Sullivan a lap down. And now he'll negotiate the B5 of Jason Barrett. Brandon Kinzer going to dive to the bottom as they work off turn number four down the front straightaway. Barrett on the bottom. Chilton going to try to sneak by on the outside of Barrett and put him a lap down into turn number three. And it looks like he's going to have that done. Clear racetrack for Chilton now for the time being. Chilton on the point, Kinzer second, Skyler Marler third, Mike Marler fourth, Dustin Linville fifth, Justin Ratliff sixth, Tommy Bailey seventh, Johnny Wheeler eighth. Wheeler the last car on the lead lap. Fifteen scored this time for race leader Michael Chilton. It's Johnny Wheeler working to the inside of Tommy Bailey. That's for the seventh spot as they race off turn number four. Robert Luttrell Jr. has pulled the 75 machine to the infield. As Chilton continues to show the way out in front. Skyler Marler trying to get racy with Brandon Kinzer. That's for the second spot. As we get set to come to the halfway signal right here. The halfway signal goes down, 18 down, 17 to go in the 15th annual Hugh June Butt Rowland Memorial. Michael Chilton shows the way. Brandon Kinzer second, Skyler Marler third, Mike Marler fourth, Dustin Linville fifth, Justin Ratliff is sixth. Tommy Bailey seventh, Johnny Wheeler eighth. Those cars on 7th and 8th, the last cars on the lead lap, and Chilton's going to have to start working them now. down the back straightaway. Chilton working traffic. He's over. We got a wreck up in turn one and two. JL Mew sideways. Johnny Wheeler has slid up to the outside retaining wall. And they had to get a couple car switch there. Second place Kendrick shows the inside. That puts third place Marler outside. Fourth place Mike Marler will be inside. Nineteener scored. Michael Chilton in charge of the restart. Eyes on him off turn number four, and here we go. Chilton leads him into turn number three. We'll come down and put the 20th lap on the board. Three wide for third. Linville the meat and the sandwich between the two Marler brothers for the moment. And Linville going to grab the third spot away from Skylar Marler. Michael Chilton, the race leader. Brandon Kinzer second, Dustin Linville third. Skylar Marler racing with older brother Mikey Marler for that fourth and fifth spot. As Dustin Linville closes up on the back bumper of Brandon Kinzer. Chilton shows the way, Linville trying to find a way around second place running Brandon Kinzer. Skylar Marler is fourth, Mike Marler fifth, Justin Ratliff sixth, Tommy Bailey is seventh. Jason Barrett looks to be eighth. Five laps complete. We'll have 26 complete this time by for race leader Michael Chilton. Brandon Kinzer second, Dustin Linville third, Mike Marler around Skylar Marler for the fourth spot as Skylar Marler's machine slows down the back straightaway, and we're going to have caution. Caution is out. Fifth place running Skylar Marler's machine slowed up in turns one and two. He's got some rear quarter panel damage on the PPM racing products remain. Chilton the leader. Kinzer is second. Linville third. Mike Marler fourth. Justin Ratliff fifth. Chilton in charge of the restart. Here we go. 10 to go. Chilton off turn two. He's got Linville looking to his inside down in turn three and four for the race lead off four. Chilton will hang on to it with nine to go. Justin Ratliff trying to get the fourth spot wrestled away from Mike Marler down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Marler slide up in front of Ratliff and retake that fourth spot. Pro Late Models to staging. Premier Integrity Solution, Pro Late Models. You're up in about six laps, or seven. Pro Late Models to staging, please. Chilton and Linville gonna try to settle it amongst themselves. Linville looking to the inside of Chilton down the back straightaway. End of turn three and off of turn number four. They'll get the five to go signal. Five trips remain in the Eugene Bud Rowland Memorial. Dustin Linville won this race in 2014, trying to go back-to-back, but he's got to find a way around Michael Chilton with four to go. Chilton showing the way. Linville is second. Kinzer third. Mike Marlow fourth. Justin Rattler fifth. Chilton and Linville down the back straightaway. If this thing stays green, they are going to encounter some slower traffic. As the field gets a two-to-go signal, Linville and Chilton make contact up in turn four, and Linville's going to go to the race lead. Chilton into the concrete as the white flag waves, one lap to settle it. Linville working down the back straightaway for the final time. Off of turn number four, Dustin Linville will win the Eugene Doug Rowland Memorial. Michael Chilton will come home second. Brandon Kinzer third. Mike Marlow fourth. Justin Rattler fifth.
Young man, congratulations. You picked your spot. Slot job, turn three and four. Tell us about it.
Chilton had to go to the lead definitely here. I hate to go to the wall there. I know he's had a lot of bad luck here lately, but man, he was a man to beat, and I think he's got hot right now, so I'm sure there'll be many wins coming for him.
No, you missed about 6 weeks there. So after 5 weeks, I guess, after the broken wrist and round left him on the floor, and it may be a blessing in disguise in a way for this race team, because you guys have just, you've had this race car sitting on keels since then. You won the final event, 49-4, Tennessee, July 3rd, followed that up the next night with the Bull Freak, a 40 win up in Brownstown, Indiana, and getting to win here from your home fans, back-to-back wins now, and then Eugene Motor on the board. Congratulations.
Thank you guys. Thank all the fans for coming out and supporting this racetrack. And yeah, we took off a month there. I had a broken wrist. The doctor says it's still broken, but he don't know I'm out here doing this stuff. But no, that month off, we got a lot of time just to go through and perfect everything. And it seems like it's paid off. I mean, every now and then you got to take off and just regroup. And it's going pretty good right now. Knock on wood. I hope we can keep it going. We sure need the money.
Once again, give a big round of applause to Dustin Linville with the 15th annual Huge Duck Rolling Memorial.